क्रिया और षटकर्मा, ओके, षटकर्मा, षटक्रियास, षट मींस व्हाट,
सिक्स,
देयर आर सिक्स मेजर क्रियास, सिक्स मेजर फेंसिंग टेक्निक्स, प्रिपरेशन प्रैक्टिसेस, क्रियास, षटकर्मा, क्रिया. It is there in the Kriya and the Pranayama. Asparti Hatayoga Pradipika, it says that Dhautir Bastis Tada Neti Tratakam Naulikam Tada Kapala Patir Shaitani Chat Karmani Prajachate. Consider the sloka. Dautir basti stada neitir. Dauti basti neiti. So these, there are six different type of kriyas. So generally we start with the kapala pati. There is a misunderstanding that this kapala pati is a pranayama, like that we call, right? In some school of yoga, teachers also as a kapala pati as a pranayama, but as per Hatha Yoga Pradipika and ancient school of yogas, Kapalabhati is kept as a kriya, cleansing technique, because it is a preparatory practice. Before doing pranayama, the cleansing, purification should happen. So that is what is happening, though preparatory stage for pranayama, isn't it? So pratyahara. In Yama Niyamas, you are saying Pratyahara is a bridge between Antaranga Yoga and Bahiranga Yoga, right? Or a preparatory stage for practicing the Antaranga Yoga. Preparatory stage for practicing Dharana, Dhyana and Samadhi, or a meditation practice, or an inward journey. Subtler forms of practices. Okay. So for that, the preparatory stage happens through Pratyahara. Or it is a bridge. So, for another way, this Kapalabhati also termed as a preparatory stage for the pranayama practices. So Kapalabhati, then Pranaka. First Kriya is Kapalabhati. Second one is Pranaka. Third one is Neti. Neti Kriyas. Neti. Neti. Then Dauti. Neti, Dauti, Nauli, Nauli and Basti, Basti or Basti, Basti is in Ayurveda, Basti, Basti Kriya. How many are there now?
Six.
Kapalabhati, Pranaka, Neti, Dauti, Nauli, Basti. Okay. So these are the Shatkriyas. Shatkriyas. Shatdarsana is different. Right?
So how is Kapala Bhati PHA?
Kapala?
Bhati.
Bhati. BHA, PHA. PHA also. Kapala Bhati. K, PHA, BHA, PHA. Kapala Bhati. First one is? Kapalam Bhati. Kapalam Bhati. Kapalam means the forehead or the skull. Okay. To shine the skull, Kapalam Bhati. Bhati means to shine, to cleanse or to purify. Kapalam Bhati. Ini Kapalam Bhati. Kapalam means what?
Skull.
It is not the skull to shine. What is there inside the skull? What it is?
Brain.
The brain. The brain to shine. Skull shining is of no use. Right. Or beautification we can do. Forehead shining. But inner thing should be shine. That is what is yoga does. More of inner cleansing. See the beauty, you see how our ancient rishis, how to look into our system, all the body, all the muscles, all the joints, all the systems, and internal organs, how they study. For really studying anatomy, physiology, by how we can cleanse it, how we can purify it, how we can strengthen it, how we can make it more healthy. That is what is the ancient Rishi Parambara of the studies of their contribution to the humanity. This Shatkriyas, okay, that is one of the major contribution to the humanity to make them more healthy. Okay, more healthy and strong in the organs, also all the eyes or the respiratory system or these what is called the whole alimentary canal or the intestines or the large or small or rectum, totally cleansing, purification, they done it through this all the Shatkriyas, Kapalam, Bhati, Kapala Bhati, which cleanses, which purifies the brain by giving more blood circulation. More blood circulation increases towards the brain, means more oxygen, more prana shakti increases. So that way it will activate the whole body through Kapala Bhati practice. All of you know Kapala Bhati, right? Forceful exhalation. Active exhalation and passive inhalation. There is no awareness on the inhalation or forceful inhalation is not happening. Active exhalation only will be happening. Flapping the stomach and then keep exhaling. Each exhalation is called a stroke, each stroke. Ideally is 120 strokes per minute. 120 strokes per minute. We need to check it. Keep the watch or the and we need to check in 1 minute how many strokes we are able to do without a break, without inhaling. Doesn't mean that we are not inhaling. We are inhaling, but
not conscious.
What? Not consciously. Means what you can say. In between each exhalation, natural inhalation will happen, but don't inhale. Then it will become bastrika. Another kriya. What is called another pranayama practice. That is a pranayama, not the kriya. Bastrika. Forceful inhalation, exhalation. That we will see in the pranayama class. But this kriya will give more exhalation or give more oxygen supply to the brain. So that is what is shining the brain means. Okay. And it activates the three systems, the respiratory system, the digestive system and the nervous system. You know, oxygen supply increases through the brain means what? The nervous system gets activated, right? So once if you see the benefit, that is one of the main benefits, right? Shirshasana, which give blood circulation increases towards the brain, means that's the king of the asana, right? Why? Because it will give complete health. Once the brain is active, the respective organs will be active, all the parts will be active. Like that, once the brain is active through Kapala Bhati, it can heal you, it can help you to be more healthy, right? So this is what is the importance of giving more prana shakti to the brain, activating the brain. So Kapala Bhati, the different type of Kapala Bhatis are there. So different type of Kapala Bhati, you can note up some of the major types of Kapala Bhati.
What should be the duration of this Kapala
Bhati? Duration in the sense?
How long?
One stretch
means about 120 strokes.
That's it.
120 strokes per minute, that is what is the duration which we can do it. That normal people around the 2 times is enough. If you are doing regularly, 2 times 120 means how many times?
240
times. That is okay. Means that is enough for your maintenance of good health. Okay. But provided if you want to further applications, further effect, what is called expectation, like weight reduction if you want to do, if you are diabetes, if you are asthmatic or respiratory disorder, you have to do more. Though it is saying that those who are having high BP and all should not do it, but can be mild weight, relaxed weight, can practice it, depending upon the age also. The youngsters also are having nowadays BP and all, right? You can do it very slowly, instead of forceful exhalation, slow exhalation. this 13 exhalations. You know that? It relaxes it like this. So normal Kapalabhati. Normal Kapalabhati means what? Both the nostrils we will be using. Both the nostrils we are forcefully exhaling. All of you do it also. Just exhale. Start exhaling, sitting erect. Flapping of your abdomen is very important. Normal. Your breakfast goes all over here. Then right nostril and left nostril. Right nostril is called the Suryanada. Left nostril is called the Chandranada. That in pranayama again we will discuss. There are 72,000 of nadis. 72,000 nadis are there. These nadis are nothing but the meridians or the channels or the energy flows through these nadis. So these, through these nadis, the energy or the pranashakti flows. So major nadis, major three nadis are Ida and Pingala and Sushumna. Ida, I-D-A, Ida. Ida is the left nostril. Left nostril is called the Ida nadi. Ida nadi. Right nostril is called the Pingala nadi. Pingala, P-I-N-G-L-A. G-A-L-A, Pingala. Ida, Pingala, Sushumna. Sushumna, S-U. S-H, U, M, N, A, Sushupna. Sushupna Nadi.
Sushupna is the
central. The cerebrospinal, central nervous system, or what you can say, the cerebrospinal fluid, which flows inner side of the vertebrae or the spinal cord. In the biological form, but it is again sushma. For general understanding, it is the right nostril is called the Pingala Nadi, left nostril is called the Ida Nadi, Surya Nadi and Chandra Nadi.
Like Surya.
Surya. It's pranayama again we need to understand in detail. Right nostril is Surya, left nostril is Chandra. Surya Kapalabhati. Surya Kapalabhati means forceful exhalation through the right nostril. Left is to be closed and the only exhalation through the right nostril. Only exhalation through the right nostril is called the Surya Kapalabhati. Then closing the right nostril, forceful exhalation through the left nostril. Right? Right? Only one nostril. Close your left nostril, left nostril. Generally we use the right hand. Left nostril with the ring finger. So this is called the Nasika Mudra. Folding the index finger and middle finger is called the Nasika Mudra. The left nostril will close with your ring and little finger together or closer. Then right nostril we have to forcefully exhale. Exhale. Only one nostril. Only through the right nostril. Closing the mouth. Not opening the mouth in between. Okay. Sound should come. Sound is very important. It is not like Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama, very silent or it is purification, cleansing. Means mucus should go out. Mucus should, cleansing should happen, cleaning should happen. Surya Kapalabhati, or Surya Nadi Kapalabhati also we can call. Surya Kapalabhati, Chandra Kapalabhati. Then Surya Bheda Kapalabhati is there. Chandra Bheda Kapalabhati is there. Surya Bheda Kapala Bhati, Chandra Bheda Kapala Bhati. Surya Bheda means inhale forcefully through the right nostril and forcefully exhale through the left nostril. It is like a bastriga. You feel like a bastriga. Inhale through the right nostril. All inhalation is through right nostril. Surya Bheda Kapalabha. Surya Bheda. There is a pranayama practice. Surya Bheda Pranayama. Chandra Bheda Pranayama. So there we do slowly. Very slowly we inhale through the right nostril, then exhale through the left nostril. That is Surya Bheda Pranayama or Chandra Bheda Pranayama. Here Surya Bheda Kapalabhati means inhale forcefully through the right nostril, then forcefully exhale through the left nostril. All of you do, try, practice. Inhale through the left nostril, exhale. No, sorry, Surya Bheda means inhale through the right nostril, forcefully exhale through the left nostril. Again, inhale through the right nostril, exhale through the left nostril. At this stage, what do you do?
Flapping of stomach is there.
Flopping is very important. Each time when you are doing, you have to flop your abdomen also.
So what is the breathing, sir? When you are breathing through the right nostril, your stomach is out there.
Always when you exhale.
Exhale stomach should go in.
Go in the sink your abdomen. When you inhale, bulge your stomach. That should be the breathing pattern. Chandra Bheda also try, inhale through the left nostril, exhale through the right nostril. Continuously do. Inhale through the left nostril. Correct. Pass. No, it is a little faster. Feel like that. Stomach should be empty. Then only that flow will become more easier.
So what is the active time for heart rate? For class 7:30.
7:30. But generally we do the theory classes in the beginning. So practice we don't do it.
Yeah.
Only few classes like this and only
have classes amazing for academic interest, so that is true.
Surya Kapalabhati and Chandra Kapalabhati and Surya Bheda Kapalabhati and the Chandra Bheda Kapalabhati. Then alternating nostril Kapalabhati, alternating nostril with the Nasika Mudra, forcefully exhale through the right, left, right, left. That generally we do in the classes, right? Active exhalation through right, left. In between, naturally the inhalation will happen. That don't bother about it. Only focus on the active exhalation. Do. Right? I have a little cold. So, right, left.
Continue.
Start flapping the stomach.
Yeah,
flap your stomach.
Stomach should go in there.
Alternating nostril, Kapalabhati. This is very common. Alternating nostril Kapalabhati and both the nostril Kapalabhati is very common, everywhere we use it. So Surya Veda, Chandra Veda, or Surya Kapalabhati, Chandra Kapalabhati is not so commonly used, but we can also.
So what is this part?
Alternative nostril Kapalabhati. Alternative nostril Kapalabhati. How many types over? Six, I think. In book and only this many only is there. We can make, create other variations also. Like inhale deeply, then exhale with the different intervals. Right? Over. That breath, if it is over, then we have to stop. Again, you have to inhale, hold the breath. Hold the breath. Somewhere around 10 times, exhale. Do it, right? Inhale, inhaling, hold the breath, then exhale with the different intervals. Same area to kind of don't do the first variation like normal Kapalabhati.
So here
also variations.
So here also flapping is.
Flapping. Flapping will happen.
But the entire air is coming out.
That much only. Don't continue with the normal Kapalabhati. There is a chance of then it continued the normal Kapalabhati just to extend the time or duration or exhalations. Not like that. Whatever you inhale, once that is over, you stop there. 4 or 5 or it can extend up to 10. You say how many times you are into try how many times you are into do exhalation. One time, one stretch. How many?
Five.
Four, seven.
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 Six. So around 10 or less, more than 5, less than 10 or it comes around. This is also very good. So every day if you make them to do only alternate nostrils, they will feel bored or for a changes. And there are some effect also when you are Surya Veda Kapalabhati, when you do Chandra Veda Kapalabhati, more stress is on the right nostril when you do the Surya Veda or Surya Kapalabhati. This more heat will be produced when you do Surya Veda. Chandra Veda means less heat will be, means cooling also happens when you do the Chandra Veda. Right nostril is always for the heat. Okay. Left nostril is always for the cooling. Come. So Surya Veda or Surya Kapalabhati or Chandra Chandra Veda Kapalabhati. Both will have its own differences for variations. Even some of the time when you do keep your head toward the right side. It can stimulate the neck and throat, thyroid region also. Keeping the head toward the left. As a variation we can do. Now 6, 7, now 8,
the
9.
The other one you said where you take the deep breath and then intervals you breathe out. What is that?
Keep the head straight.
What is that?
There is no particular minimum sense. Deep inhalation, exhale with the different breaths. As a new variation you can write. You want to make a new name? Andar Kumbhaka Kapalabhati. Andar Kumbhaka means inhale, hold the breath. It's called Kumbhaka. Okay, Andar Kumbhaka. Inhale, hold the breath. Andar Kumbhaka Kapalabhati. New name is being given. Kapalabhati.
If we do side also, we have to
that is normal Kapalabhati. Normal Kapalabhati. Forceful exhalation. Generally that is Bastriga we do is 21 times. Kapalabhati is ideally 120 strokes per minute. If you want to reduce the weight and all, you need to do some 500 times.
But initially that sound will come later
than sound. Which is sound? Exhalation. Slowly
that
becomes in the sunya. no sound. Conscious effort should be there. All this kapalabhati we can do with the pressing the palms, either with the alternative we are releasing. Left palm you can keep it on your stomach. So the pressing will help you to do the flapping of your stomach, because the digestive system will activate only if you press your flappier abdomen. Flapping, if it is naturally, if it is not happening, or in the beginners, what we can do is ask them to keep your palms on the stomach and start pressing. Press, press. Each exhalation, that movement will happen. A balloon like movement will happen. Or both the nostrils if you are doing. Digestion. Try. Press, press. There is more effect will be there.
Balance means what? Both the side of the brain will get balanced.
Both the blocks of the brain is having its own function, right? One is of aggressiveness, energy, in brilliance. Another is creativity and calm, relaxed, isn't it? So this balancing is very important. So we know that right part of the brain is controlling the left part of the body and vice versa, right? The same way, it needs to be balanced. It is not we should be dominant over other or one should be in upper hand, nothing like that. We should have a balance of both. So Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama, and that will help you. To do Nadi Shuddhi or any other part of the Pranayama, this Kapalabhati is very important. To practice Kapalabhati, open up the nostrils, open up the nasal passage, open up the respiratory system, so that you will be able to do Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama or any other further practice of Pranayama. That's why it is called a preparatory practice. Kapalabhati is a preparatory practice. So balancing will happen. Ida, Pingala, Nadis, balancing is very important. For different diseases also. Different. For example, if you have BP, you should do more of Chandrabheda Kapalabhati or Chandradinom Virom Pranayama, Chandranadi Pranayama, like that we call it. Pranayama will explain. Those who are having low BP, they should do Surya Bheda Kapalabhati, Surya Nilom Vilom Pranayama, Surya Bheda Kapalabhati, Surya Bastrika, this all they have to do it. Means more energy, more heat, more. If you want to reduce the weight also, right nostril breathing, right nostril Kapalabhati, right nostril Pranayama, you should do it. So that you will get more heat and the metabolic rate increases. So that it will help you to reduce the weight. And that way, both the nostrils are having its own function. Those are having headache, those are complaint of migraine. They should do more of right nostril, those are having the headache at all, they should do more of left nostril. Again, it is calming down. Those are in depression. What they should do? Depression. They should do
right
nostril. Right nostril. Means they are very cool, very lethargic. No enthusiasm, depression. They should do right nose, means they will make you more energetic, more active, more. Those who are into hypertension, anxiety, what they should do? Left nostril breathing they should do. Left nostril Kapalabhati they should do. Left nostril breathing. Left nostril means what? Chandra Veda Pranayama, Chandra Nilo Milo Pranayama, that they have to do it. Those who are into depression.
So after depression, what is it? After depression?
Anxiety.
Anxiety left, right?
Left. Yes, we are done. So this Kapalabhati also, you can check also when your nostril is blocked, one particular nostril is blocked. Right nostril is blocked. What do you have to do? Right nostril is blocked means Surya Kapalabhati you should do it. Then you will open up. Isn't it? Surya Kapalabhati you should do it. So those who are having headache and all, they should do the left nostril breathing more. After getting up every morning, you do the left nostril.
One question. If the body itself decides to block one, which means maybe the body requires that particular nostril to be blocked. Maybe there is a lot of energy that is generated, and therefore it blocks right and then raises the left.
Somebody is calling for the classes.
We will call later.
You want the number?
Afternoon we will call.
Like you said, yes. The body system is designed in such a way that there is a lot of heat that gets generated. Maybe the right gets blocked and the left is released. So would it be detrimental to release the right again?
That's what it is not to be lethargic, to be inactive is our inner result tendency. Right. That is the nature. But we cannot allow to that. Right. We have to give the suggestions. So there is a lot of chances of being negative. There is a lot of chances for that. Doesn't mean that we have to be like that. We should allow to it. We should overcome it. Right. So this practice will make you to be healthy. So, if depression is there or any problem is there, we be with that is not the stage. We come out of that. For that, these practices are there. We know that this nostril is for this function and this nostril is for this function. And let it be what the divine feelings or divine, what is, it is God's given gift or God's play. So whatever be the nostril, it wanted to be active, let it be. I don't disturb. That is, you know, the way. So both the nostrils function is there, and pranayama help you to activate both the nostrils. So you have to make it active for the nostrils through regular pranayama. Otherwise, and generally it is better to do the left nostril breathing in the early morning to be healthy, to be, you know, that is generally we say close the right nostril, inhale, exhale through the left nostril. Down. So you be very calm and quiet in the next morning days, or you feel very fresh.
Left
nostril kapalbhati, as well as there is a pranayama practice also. Pull it through the inhalation, exhalation through the left nostril. Let's hold the chandra nilo viloma pranayama. Pranayama will teach you. So 6, 7, 8. Type of kapalabhati we see. So more important is alternative nostril kapalabhati, both the nostrils kapalabhati, surya kapalabhati, chandra kapalabhati. These are the major kapalabhati. Some 5 type of kapalabhati you should be able to do. Okay. What is the benefit of kapalabhati? Shining the skull, brain, activate the brain cells. Means more oxygen supply increases to the brain. When you clean the nostrils, means what? Cleansing the nostrils and the lungs also. Purification happens. Lung capacity increases. Lung capacity increases. Another is the digestive system. When you flap your abdomen, all the internal organs get a
activated.
What is called contraction and expansion happens to the internal system, whether it is a stomach, whether it is a large intestine or small intestine, kidney, liver, all pancreatic glands or the digestive systems or the glands get stimulated, activated, right? So gallbladder or related organs get stimulated, so liver, kidney, that's why for the diabetes and all, the kapalabhati practice is a good medicine. We can practice regularly those are having diabetes because pancreas get a lot of compression and the expansion happens to the pancreatic glands. It stimulates so that insulin secretion becomes normal.
So does it happen like when we are used to the stimulation? Like you get used, these organs get used to it. Unless until there is a stimulant, like it doesn't secrete.
It's not used to it. It is a problem. That's why diabetes people are asked to go for walking or we are prone to be lazy. Go beyond it, go against it. Isn't it? What is the tendency early morning when you get up or before getting up? To sleep again.
Switch
off or isn't it? Before coming to yoga class, what is the first thinking? No, it will be next tomorrow I will go. Or today is Friday, so next day and tomorrow anyhow it is holiday, so let me go from Monday. 6 o'clock batch will think, let me go for 7 o'clock, right? So lethargy to be alasya is our inner tendency. How we overcome is important. Our organs also get used to it. You know? Organs also don't want to get involved in the physical exercise. We want to be relaxed. So more relaxation is more inertia, lethargy, negative energy, and it gets, you know, activeness won't happen. Unless and until that activeness is not there, that organ become very subtler or what can I say, very stagnation happens. Stagnation happens to the organs. So unless there is no movement, there is no compression or expansion, the oxygen supply will not increase. Means what? The blood circulation also will not be increased. See, simple, when you do an asana, vakrasana, and not in is a best medicine for diabetes we call Prasad. Just hold right leg, twist and sit. 5 minutes is it. This also can heal the diabetic problems because the pancreas gets stimulated, or Ardha Valsiyadurasana also. It is nothing but stimulating that particular organ, stimulating that pancreas gland. So regular practice will happen, but it will help you to, you know, give more oxygen supply. Half the problem can be solved. When oxygen supply increases, it can activate. Pavana Muktasana, when you fold your both legs and lie down, what is happening? The intestine get
contraction
and stimulation happens, so that the digestive tract gets activated, the digestion become normal. This simple way we heal the different diseases, isn't it? Pachimottanasana when you do, bending forward, the whole digestive system and the skeleton, the system gets stimulated. This simple way we stimulate, activate, expansion and stimulation. By that way, give more oxygen supply, more prana shakti, and heal the organs. No need of external medicine.
So what layman question? You said early morning we are lazy. But we are supposed to be activating the left nostril.
Left nostril.
It's like to understand.
It is calming down. It is again to relax your mind.
I am already relaxing.
Then after getting up only.
I'm already relaxing. Right? Lazy. More or less we would like to go back to bed. So by doing that, are we exercising that particular thing and stimulating the brain or something?
It is, another aspect is when you do the left nostril breathing, what, where, which part of the brain is active?
Right.
The right part of the brain will be getting activated. The right part is for what? Right part of the brain?
Analytical.
Then? Memory also. And more of what we can say, the right part of the brain is again to relax. Relaxation also happens. Right part of the brain. So, for that, left nostril breathing should be done. That's why left nostril breathing when you do, you can reduce the headache. Headache people should do the left nostril breathing. And pressing the tip of the fingers, squeezing the eyebrows, sigh. And the ears also the same. It's all the same.
Migraine.
Sinus means again you have to do the other kriyas. Neti, nam. And everything should balance with the nadi shuddhi pranayama. So these three systems get activated through the Kapalabhati practice. Which are the systems? Digestive system, respiratory system, nervous system. If these three systems are active, means you can be healthy. Right?
90%.
90%. Most of the problems happens through stomach.
Yeah, thinking and what we eat.
So that's why our Ramdevji and our go on telling, do Kapalabhati, for all problems do Kapalabhati.
He suggests for 15 to 20 minutes.
More than 500 times. But anything excess is also
not
too much of heat produced.
Each is all kind of
thing. Yeah. 200, 240 and all is balanced. For normal people is enough. One of my clients was there, he used to do some 500 times daily. Though he had high BP. Every time lot of mucus, respiratory problem is also, lot of mucus will come out. And that tissue paper, no? One bottle, one packet will be kept, and one packet will be empty in one day. You know, so much of, by the time you go, he will start and it will
be. Like you already said, one of the classes, the three things, Pitta,
Kapha,
I think he will work Kapha.
Kapha nature.
Is
it like good? If you enjoy, you do it. Depend upon you. If you are enjoying, you are happy, and you are. He
See,
says that I feel if I don't do 500 times of Kapalabhati, I feel lethargic. I feel I don't feel, and I don't have any much difference of my BP. Though I had BP, I don't have. Like you know, what is Mahatma Gandhi says, you know, his BP was more than 200, and the systolic itself. So it doesn't make much variations. If you are happy, you
can see results.
Yeah. But Yoga Shastra says if you are having high BP, you should not practice Kapalabhati. But limitation means what is called other aspect is there. If you are happy and if you are getting good result, that's why Rabdevji also says if you are having BP also you do it like that. But Vivekananda Kendra such organization says if you have BP, don't do it. It is more of medical or precautions, more of analysis they have done it. Means blood pressure or heart problems, you should. What I say is you take care of yourself. If you are happy, you do it, or don't do it too much. Anything excess is harmful. And if you have BP or heart problems also, do, but very slowly. Careful also, and the benefit also will come very slowly. So these three systems to activate this way, this preparatory stage, this kriya is very, very important. Kapalabhati, practicing regular. So in the classes also we do at the beginning, right? Because you get more energetic, more heat increases and you know, lot of power happens to your body. That's why in the beginning of the classes also nowadays. That is reason the practice only. Earlier it was not there. Before, after Shavasana and only at the end only Kapalabhati used to practice. But nowadays many yoga students start with the Kapalabhati or Bastriga, so that through this practice you will get lot of power. But whatever we do, we should be very relaxed in the way we should do it, not with the strain and you know, different type of Kapalabhati. What is the posture which is good for Kapalabhati? Sitting erect. Spine should be erect and aligned with the spine and neck. Then we have to do it. What is the posture? Vajrasana is very good. Padmasana is good. These are the two asanas which is very good for the Kapalabhati practice. Other any sitting asanas like Siddhasana, Ardha Padmasana, Sukhasana. Last option is Sukhasana. But everybody prefers that.
Vajrasana and
Padmasana. Ardha Padmasana, Padmasana. There is a Siddhasana. Siddhasana in asanas we will discuss. It is like Ardha Padmasana when you sit. There are 100 reasons are there for a day. While you do Kapalabhati, you may hit, there is a chances of getting headache. That's a good question. Means, what can be the reason?
Breathing is not right.
More of heat. Heat is produced.
Also produced.
Heat can be produced. More of heat. That is one reason. And wrong practices.
Yeah.
Wrong practices can create problems for headache. Of course, everybody gets in the beginning time when something is not used, something is not practiced, or something is not used. When you start using it, there is a chance. When oxygen supply increases, there is a chance. Other aspect is skewing the spine, skewing the head if you practice Kapalabhati. If you are not practicing in empty stomach,
Pardon?
In the, you can sit in the chair also and do it. Depend upon the age group and all inconvenience. Those are having knee problem or they can't sit for long. Then sit there and do it. Standing is not so good. Nowadays in the park also they will do Kapalabhati, Bastriga and all in the park also, they does it. But swalpam alpasya dharmasya, at least little bit of benefit is also good, or little bit of practice is also good, right? Even though you won't get full benefit, but you will get benefit. So facial expression should be very relaxed and not squeezing. Some people nose will go, some people mouth will, then squeezing, some pocket will go. This all facial expression should avoid. Very relaxed way. there is no change. Now, half of the participants, if you see in the face, lot of facial exercise they will do.
Lot of effort.
Effort. Should happen effortless way. Slowly, the moving the body. It will come down or come to the side. The restriction is so, let me take helper. It's all movements will take care. Alasya, progress is not there. So body should be spine erect, then only the Sushupna Nadi. See this Ida Pingala joined with the Sushupna. So Sushupna has to be active, then you sit erect. And Vajra Nadi, when you sit in Vajrasana, Vajra Nadi gets activated. Effect on it when you do erect. When you bend, there is a little bit different. Keeping the spine, the personality also improves and there will be, you know, confidence when you practice it. And the alasya goes, the tamas goes, the darji goes when you sit like that.
The inner eye will open.
Inner eye will open when you or close the eyes and practice. Or open the eyes and you will be checking
the distraction.
Distraction. Sense organs will be searching. Search of happiness, right? Pratyahara. Okay. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Correct. Once if you know, you can close your eyes. Okay, better to close your eyes. Nothing to balance here, right? Only for balancing, you open your eyes. Here, there is nothing to balance. Only balancing asanas or backward bending postures, you can open your eyes. Kapalabhati, it's better to. Close your eyes and practice.
So that is also one of the reasons why they recommend that you sit.
Sit erect. When you stand, you will lose balance. And you cannot stand for long and there is energy, balance happens. Sit, relax. See, Kapalabhati and all is an end practice after asanas, generally. Form of exercise, Surya Namaskara, Asana, relaxation, then Kapalabhati for progression for Pranayama, Pranayama and then meditation. So then we sit only. All Pranayama we sit and do it, not standing. For what? That is a preparatory stage for meditation.
Sir, what is the sequence?
Surya Namaskara, Asanas, Shavasana, then Kapalabhati or Pranayama. Meditation.
Shavasana? After Shavasana?
Kapalabhati.
And
then? Then Pranayama. Any type of Pranayamas. Pranayasuddhi or Vastrika. Pranayama sequence also when you take it is stimulating, relaxing. Stimulating, relaxing. Stimulating, relaxing. In between also we are supposed to do some Shavasana. Like? QRT, IRT, PRT. Last DRT or deep relaxation or yoga nidra. If you have a bad time, yoga nidra and then Kapalabhati. Again stimulating. Then relaxing pranayamas will come later on. Sexual breathing and then again stimulating through Bhastrika. Then relaxation through Nadishuddhi pranayama. Then Bhramari. Then it again stimulating the brain. Then meditation. Then taking Sankalpa and then concluding the session. Generally we require all together if you practice around 1.5 hours of practice should be there. Generally we can justify all. Otherwise we compromise on basically on pranayama and meditation. Last part will be very hurry in the class. Actually for that only we do all. For meditating or we doing pranayama only we do asanas or Surya Namaskara or other practices. Making the body fit enough for what? To do pranayama. Why you are doing pranayama? Doing meditation. So we compromise on that. When we class also, when we say today we will do meditation means half of the parts are no need of pranayama, but it's called meditation. We will do Surya Namaskara, Prasadas. Physical body only, they attach to the physical body. They attach to the I am what means I am my body. I want to reduce my weight. That is the purpose of yoga. That way we.
Some states by doing asana, the inhalation and exhalation, that is only your pranayama. You need not to do something.
Yeah, that is what I, Ashtanga Vinyasa, it is through Ujjayi Pranayama, they do it. But how many of you will do throughout the session focus on the breathing? Even in the 12 rounds of Surya Namaskara, how many of you will do with the deep inhalation, exhalation? How many of you will do Ashtanga Namaskara, exhale, hold a breath? Do we do it sincerely? Many times it becomes mechanical, isn't it? Through instructions.
So it focuses more on the posture than on breathing.
Is it? We identify ourselves with the body. I have this body. Our knowledge should go beyond it. I have this not body. And this body is only an instrument to repair of my inner consciousness. That way of jnana should be. Jnana yoga should be repair of. Next is Trataka. Trataka. TRNGAK, Trataka. Trataka. Is gazing. Intensely gazing. Focusing. Separately, when you do a session, Jatra Tranaga, Jyoti Tranaga, we can start with the Triyokara, Om Asatoma Sargame or Sahana Udha prayer, or at the end, we can have Asatoma Sargame prayer. Like that, whatever session we can do, Tranaga sessions. But in class, generally in between, we can do Jatra Tranaga. Jatra Tranaga is mostly for the hands movement, we do it, Jatra Tranaga. As a preparatory stage for the Trataka, any type of Trataka is eye exercises. All of you are familiar with the eye exercise, eye movements. Clear? And the palmings. This we should know. Palming. How to do palming and eye movements. There are different type of palming. Different type of palms. Normal palming means what? Rub the both palms and keep it the both adversaries and massage. That is called normal palm. Here different type of palmings. Why we do palming? To energize. Heat is produced here and you get more energy, you feel more fresh. Okay. And cooling, what you can say, relaxation to the eye muscles will happen when you do the palming. Okay. Means after closing the eyes, immediately before opening the eyes, we need to give the freshness to the eye muscles. That will protect your eyes instead of directly looking in the light. That's why early morning we are supposed to what? We have to chant the prayer like Karagri Vasate Lishmi Karamate Saraswati Karamuli Sne Gopi Prabhade Karadashi. This we are supposed to say. Why? Because that energy we get it and feel the divine blessings or the presence, and then you get up and start the day. So here also when you closing the eyes after Shavasana, any type of Shavasana or in prana, what is called Pranayama or meditation or Trataka, when you do in between, when you close your eyes before opening directly or see the light, we have to keep the bath and energize and then gently bring your eyes and open, either looking down and then look toward the light. So rub you both the palms and make it like a cup, not directly. Yeah? We are not supposed to press the eyes directly. So make it like a cup and keep it like this, not like this, yeah? Like this. So that the side of the eye muscles get the warmness. Okay. So first palming is normal palming, massaging the face. Next is palming with the pressure. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Palming with the pressure and the breathing. Okay, palming, normal palming, then palming with the pressure, then palming with the pressure and breathing. Third one, normal palming, palming with the pressure. Third one is palming with the pressure and the breathing. Inhale, press, exhale. Inhale, press, exhale. Then around three times. Fourth one is pressing and the
releasing.
No, not releasing. Press, inhale and the do the Bhramari. Okay. Inhale, press. Then exhalation time, gently release. Releasing means we are not releasing fully, keeping there only, reduce the pressure. Inhale, press. Same way, anticlockwise direction, and do palming.
just to motivate the team, sir, I used to wear that glass, the 40 plus. So I used to wear that glass and then three boots. Now without that, I can read because of this.
High exercise. Good. Awesome. We can reduce the power of your lungs with the regular practice of high exercise as well as the Jyoti Pranayama. Of course, you have to take food also accordingly, which help you for the eyes. Tomato, process type of food items, carrot. Carrot is good for eyes.
That is Jyotitravadaka is done with
After eye exercises.
Okay.
Eye exercises, different forms of eye exercises we can do. Concluding functions. For tea break. So, the looking toward the shoulder also we can do. Right shoulder, left shoulder, right shoulder, left shoulder. The eyebrow corners, both the side also we can look. And even any objects we can see. Even the balls we can just move sidewise. That also become good exercise. Even kids are not, if you tell all exercise, they won't do it. So we can play the method, we can make the things to see the sidewise. And the squeezing the eyes also very good exercise for the eyes. Even some people just with the two fingers get massage, that also massage the kids. Even applying the, saliva on the eyebrows or the side of the eyes, that also protect the eyes.
Middle finger.
Different ways of eyes. So here what we will do, the different around the nine type of Jyotitradaka. Jyotra. The meaning is collar board. Meaning Jyotra. Jyotra. Shoulder or collar board. Means movement of Jyotra. Shoulder movements will happen. Hand movement. Hasta. Dakshina Jyotitradaka. First one is Dakshina. Dakshina. D-A-K-S-I-N-A. D-H also, some people write Dakshina.
That's okay. Is that the direction? Dakshina is the direction.
Which one?
Dakshina, you say, is it direction?
Right side. Dakshina drip means you look at the right side. In army and navy, Dakshina drip, Vama drip, Puro drip. Puro drip means look this way. Dakshina drip, Vama drip. For correction of the lines, no? In NCC and all over is there, the correction happens. The line. Dakshina drip. All of you will look toward the right side. Only the person who is the right hand will look straight. So we have to see the chin of the third person, not the right second person. The third person chin you have to see and then correct your alignment, movement in south hand position. Dakshina drip. After correction, the next instruction will come Puro drip. Then everybody has to look straight. Dakshina drip.
Left is called
Purva.
Straight is
Purva. That is Purva. Dakshina. Vama also. Like Pachima and Uttara. Front and back. Dakshina. Vama. Vama drip means left side.
So here both Dakshina is Vama.
Dakshina Jyotitradaka. What do you do? Keep your hand straight front. Look at the thumb. The tip of the nail or the thumb we have to see. And slowly you have to move the eyeballs towards the right side. As much you can. Then slowly you have to bring your hands towards the straight front. Okay, good, right. Sit straight. Keep your head straight, bend. Look at the boy. Don't close the eyes. Eyes are open and wide. With a relax the face. Without moving the head, don't move the head. Eyes only will move. Eyeballs. Go to the right side. Don't take the left hand. Stand round. Then it becomes lama. Then left hand. Take the left hand straight front. Look at the point. Go the thumb towards the left side. Without moving the head. Head is straight. Many of your head also moves. Eyes don't blink. Eyes are open and wide. So 5 times Dakshina can do, Bama can do some 5 times. By the time you are, Jethro will feel.
It's master
to
thumb only,
You can index finger also, you can. It is not convenient actually. Some people does with this also.
So,
And after that, you have to close your eyes and do a rubbing bath. If you do 5 times off. Next is a Dakshina Chaturthraadaka, Vama Chaturthraadaka, then Urdhva Muha Chaturthraadaka, Urdhva, U-R-D-H-V-A, Mukha, M-U-K-H-A, Urdhva Muha Dakshina Chaturthraadaka, Urdhva Muha Dakshina, D-A-K-S-I-N-A, Dakshina Chaturthraadaka. Urdhva Mukha Dakshina Chaturthraadaka means right hand up. Okay. Urdhva Mukha. Urdhva Mukha means upward. Okay. Adho Mukha means downward. Downward dog pose is there, no? What is called the downward dog pose and the upward dog pose. Parvadasana and Bhujangasana. Urdhva Mukha Svanasana and the Adho Mukha Svanasana. Urdhva Mukha. Upward. Urdhva Mukha Dakshina Chaturthraadaka, taking the right hand up. Means like this also we can do, like this also we can do. Right? Slowly raise the right hand up. Without moving the head only, eyeballs will move. Then straight down. Fully up and straight. Let's go to Urdhva Mukha Dakshina Chaturthraadaka. Then left hand, how it will become? Urdhva Mukha. Vama Chaturthraadaka. Urdhva Mukha Vama Chaturthraadaka. Down how it will be? Adho Mukha Dakshina Chaturthraadaka. Adho Mukha Dakshina Chaturthraadaka. Adho Mukha Vama Chaturthraadaka. Adho Mukha
A-D-H-O.
Urdhva Mukha Vama.
Urdhva
Mukha Dakshina Chaturthraadaka. Urdhva Mukha Vama Chaturthraadaka. Adho Mukha. That is Adho Mukha. Fifth one. Adho Mukha. A-D-H-O, M-U-K-H-A. Adho Mukha Dakshina Chaturthraadaka. Right hand down. Adho Mukha Vama Chaturthraadaka. Left hand, left thumb down. Left thumb when you take it down, it is called Adho Mukha Vama Chaturthraadaka. You have to try? Right. Right hand down. Keep your right hand straight front. Look at the point. Slowly drop your, without closing the eyes, drop your right hand down. C. see the same point. Don't look at somebody's thumb. Your own thumb. Without moving the head. Some of your head also is doing pranayama. Only eyes. Got tired? Then, vama also do. Vama. Adhomuha vama chetra pranayama. Adhomuha vama chetra pranayama. Slowly, slowly down, then slowly. Those are eye problems you can do regularly. Daytime also you can do, that is advantage, right?
Body requires.
Very relaxing also. Good exercise for your shoulder, hands also.
These can be combined, sir. Adhoma and.
You can combine. These for just knowledge or study purpose, we do it separately. Otherwise, we can combine. Up and down, we can do continuously also.
Variations.
Variations. To find variations. First one is? Dashtina. Chitrutradaga. Then? Vama Chitrutradaga. Then? Urdha Muha Chitrutradaga. Dakshina and Vama. Then? Adhomuha Dakshina. Adhomuha Vama. Then both the hands when you use, it is called Ubhaya Chitra Pradana. Ubhaya Chitra Pradana. Right hand. Ubhaya. U-B-H-A-Y-A. Ubhaya. U-B-H-A-Y-A. Ubhaya. Ubhaya Varga is there, no? What is called?
Ubhaya Chitra.
Both.
Sir, Ubhaya Chitra.
Ubhaya Chitra Pradana. What is it? Sri Linga, Pullinga, Ubhaya. Something is there. The book said it. Both the sides. But both the sides we will not look here and there. We will see spread only. Looking at the center, keep your hand straight, friend. Feel the thumb. It is focusing on a point, you defocus your mind towards the thumb. Feel the thumb. Right? Not take too much, then you cannot feel at all. Up to side of the ears and all. Up to here. Yes. Then looks fine, friend. Don't look here and the new pranaga. Don't look at me. Look at the straight front. One point you have to select.
This should be like physical.
Defocusing. Focusing on a point, defocus your mind. Dharana is meditation is nothing but focusing is meditation. Defocusing is dhyana.
Defocusing is what, sir?
Dhyana. Focusing is dharana. Different type is there. Like urdha muha, adho muha we can do. Up and down also we can do. We can keep your thumb straight also. Means up and down facing also we can do. Like this also we can do. Like this also we can do. This is more convenient. Okay. Up and down when you do. Like this. Urdha muha and adho muha together. Looking at the same point. This sideways we can do. Diagonal also we can do. Okay. Diagonal. So this itself different variations we can take. Both the sides, up and down, diagonal, even rotation also we can do. Make it like thumb, then rotation also we can do. Eye rotate, this is nothing but eye rotation only. Eye rotation instead of rotating, it can be considered as part of the Ubhaya Chitrutradaka. Single hand also we can do. Rotation, seeing the thumb like this. Or clockwise you do with the right hand. Anti-clockwise do with the left hand. different forms of Upaya Chaturthadhaka. Both the sides, up and down, diagonal and rotation. Upaya Chaturthadhaka. Upaya Chaturthadhaka, the rotation we consider as an eye exercise also, but in Upaya Chaturthadhaka also we can do rotation. Okay, both the ways we can do it. Up and down, sidewise, diagonal, yeah. Corner to corner, and rotation. Rotation, clockwise and clockwise. Around 5 times and only, sir. Upaya Chaturthadhaka. Which one is 7th one, no? 8th one is Nasagra Chaturthadhaka. Nasagra. N-A-S-A-G-R-A. Nasagra. Nasagra Tradaka or Nasagra Jantra Tradaka. Nasagra Jantra Tradaka. Nasagra means what? Nasa, Nasiga. Nasa Agra means the tip of the nose. Gazing at the tip of the nose. By keeping the thumb, okay, keep your hands straight front, then slowly bring it, looking at the same point, you have to bring your thumb towards the tip of the nose, bring it closer, when we can touch also, bring it as closer, gaze it for some time, and again take it to distance. Little heaviness or pressure happens to the eyes, and again repeat, bring it closer, closer, slowly. See the same point, concentration, dharana. You can touch also or keep a little gap also. Seeing the thumb, don't see somebody in there. See the thumb with the opened eyes. Nasagra Chaturthadhaka. If you take to the eyebrow center, it becomes Bhrumadhya. Bhrumadhya Chaturthadhaka. Bhru, B-H-R-U. B-H-R-U, N-A, E-H-Y-A. Bhrumadhya. Bhrumadhya. Nasa is eyebrow center. Gazing. These are preparatory stage for meditation also. The ninth one is, what is the ninth one?
Bhrumadhya.
Bhrumadhya Chaturthadhaka. Dakshina.
Upaya Jatra is seven.
Upaya.
Upaya Jatra
is seven. Upaya is seven. Then Nasagra and Bhrumadhya. Instead of tip of the nose, you have to bring your thumb towards the eyebrow center. When it comes closer, you have to maintain for some time. Okay, wherever you are comfortable. See there, little gaze. See the concentration also improves, right? Stimulate the Ajna Chakra also, no? Third eye. Stagnation should not be there. Don't stop anywhere. Continuous movement should be there. Only when it comes closer, you have to stop it and gaze for a while with open eyes. Eyes are open and wide. And again, take this. Once you feel tired with your right hand, Dakshina. Hasta is tired, Vama Hasta can be used. So what are they? First one is? Dakshina. Then? Vama. Urdhva. Dakshina. Urdhva. Atha. Vama. Atha. Muha. Then? Upaya Chaturthadhaka. Nasagra and the Bhrumadhya. These are the different types of Chaturthadhakas. it out. In between, we have to do palming. Okay, simple palming or palming with the pressure or palming with the pressure and the breathing. On the way, depend upon the availability of time. Or one or two combine, you do it and do palming. If you don't do palming, it will damage your eyes. Okay, in between, palming is a must. Either each time you do or after two times or three times you do the palming. We'll have a short break, no?
Yes, sir.
We'll have a short break and we'll go.
So focusing is dharma.
Focusing is dharma.
Focusing is
Guru.
Meditation.
Guru.
The focusing is dharma.
That we will see later. Huh?